Monday, November 14th, approximately 5 a.m. All the stray cats were fed and accounted for and given fresh food and fresh water. Both Meow Meow and One-Eyed returned today, and I made sure to give them some of that gourmet food somebody sent me. Thank you so much. They loved it. My favorite show growing up was The Wonder Years, and it used a voiceover kind of like what I do for these daily monologues. The Wonder Years also had a great soundtrack of classic rock and Motown songs. It had things that I like and know about, like the written word, popular music, and the feeling of nostalgia. Very few TV shows growing up had more of an impact on me than The Wonder Years. It helped shape how I see the world and, more importantly, how I look back at the past. TV shows meant a lot to me growing up because the quote-unquote family I lived with didn't like me, let alone love me. They abused and neglected me and made me and my brother sleep in a closet in the garage. Every time we saw a nice family on TV, we would pretend that we were part of that family. Many famous actors got their start on The Wonder Years. It was like lightning in a bottle. Alicia Silverstone got her first acting gig on The Wonder Years in 1992. Seth Green played a memorable leader of the group of bad kids on The Wonder Years. Before the TV show Friends cut off, David Schwimmer was on The Wonder Years for 4 episodes. Juliette Lewis had a small role on The Wonder Years, and both Screech and Zach Morris from Saved by the Bell before Saved by the Bell got started on The Wonder Years. Other actors include John Corbin, Breckin Meyer, Giovanni Ribisi, and Punky Brewster, a.k.a. Sailor Moon Fry. I know a lot of the way they used music connected with nostalgia had an effect on me. I have a good taste in music, and having a good taste in music is actually a more desirable trait than people realize. What kind of music a person listens to can tell you a lot about them. Someone like me, who listens to all types of music, isn't the type of person to get upset over small things. And the saddest, most unhappiest people are the ones who don't listen to any music at all. I once had to spend 2 months in a boot camp when we weren't allowed to listen to music, and music was the thing I missed most. No matter where I've been in life, whether I'm homeless or in a million-dollar mansion, music has always been there for me, a soundtrack. I was raised on MTV. Both my brother and I weren't given toys when we were kids, so we had to be creative in other ways, like while watching music videos. There's a particular language that goes with music videos. It was invented in the 80s, and this music video montage have stood the test of time. New alternative music that comes out today gets the same 1980s music video treatment with young people from today. They turn their favorite songs into a 1980s music video, and they usually use 1980s movies too. It works well together, the movies and the music. I suppose these young people were inspired by their predecessors. Everybody have a great day, and don't forget where you came from. My name is Gregory Brandt. Yeah. Oh, baby, how do you all I need is my brother. I say I'm gonna get high.